Ringside, Los Angeles Sports Arena, and the boos you hear are for the big outlaw, Ron Bass. This one is a vendetta.
This contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Houston, Texas, weighing 290 pounds, the outlaw, Ron Bass.
Got those spurs on. Brett
His
and
opponent
Bart.
This evening, weighing 271 pounds, from San Francisco, California, Brutus the Barber Beefcake.
Listen to this ovation.
They're on their feet. Imagine this many humanoids cheering on Cheesecake.
Los Angeles Sports Arena is rocking.
I don't like that music.
I do.
Oh, there goes the bell right off the bat. These two have been dying and itching to get their hands on each other.
Is he dressed?
Very. It's one of his favorite outfits.
And the outlaw's down, and a big right hand sends him down again. And Brutus is on fire.
He doesn't even have his jacket off.
Doesn't matter, the bell rang.
Or is that a jacket? I don't know what it is.
Trying to make quick work. Well, not quick work. He wants this guy to feel some of the punishment, some of the payback.
Well, he asked for it. He started by cutting that bullwhip in half. It was none of his business. He's been cutting people's hair for a couple years now. He's been choking people. He doesn't do anything to a man face to face. He waits till he's out.
These two guys are going to have a big role coming up very shortly. Thanksgiving night, Richfield Coliseum, Richfield, Ohio, the location for Survivor Series. Undoubtedly the biggest pay-per-view event of 1988 for the World Wrestling Federation and for fans all over the world.
You know, the other day I'm going through LaGuardia Airport, New York, Survivor Series, everybody's talking about pay-per-view. They're having friends over, big Thanksgiving night, turkey, no more football, they're watching wrestling.
Oh, look at this, the action is gone to the concrete here. I knew the ring wouldn't be able to hold these two guys. Oh! Rammed him in there. Brutus having it all his own way. Here on the West Coast.
He didn't exactly have it his way on the East Coast, did he?
I don't even think about that.
Oh, no, you can't.
Doing the strutting. Perhaps soon he'll be doing the cutting.
Obvious by his ring apparel that there's a closet full of moths.
Does he get it any cheaper because he doesn't use all the material? I often wonder that.
Probably. As far as I'm concerned, he's cheap.
I'll tell you, this Bass is a handful.
Oh, he's a big, mean man.
Nasty person.
Only man I knew when May came around the summer, everything started to get hot. He grew a beard.
You weren't here the night he came out and challenged me right here on Z Channel, were you?
Oh, that's when the 14 cops had to pull you out from under the ring.
Will you stop it?
Hurt.
Wasn't worried about his opponent, he was worried about me. I never did anything to the guy. Oh, downstairs, right in the breadbasket. Oh. My grandmother could have got out from under that one. Boy, did he telegraph that move.
Grandmother's a wrestler?
No, but you could have got out of that one. I guess you're wrestling with Grandpa. Ones to the nose.
Those girls though always got a little pair of trimming shears
tucked away.
Ring the bell, ring the bell.
What do you mean ring the
That's
bell?
That's illegal, that's a weapon.
Oh, look at that Bass bailing out of there.
Turn the mic over to the referee immediately. Did you see that?
I'm sure he had to. Somebody better get
Oh, look at this, a steel chair thrown in by the outlaw. And Brutus saying, I'm going to put it right here and sit down and wait for you to come back in. Come and get me.
Bass, Bass, come over here. The scissors are over here.
Would you stop?
He tried to use them on Bass.
You see what's going on up there, Bobby? You see he's got a chair right there.
I know he does. I do. I told the ref.
Listen to the cry, baby. Get in the ring. That's what you come out here for. been hollering and screaming on TV, you want this guy inside the ring at the worst moment. Now he's in there waiting for you.
Having the man pull the scissors out. Gonna cut his hair. Who knows what else he's gonna cut?
Bass would never do anything like that, would he? He would never resort to using Miss Betsy or Brett or Bart, would he?
But yes, I think he would.
Well, I'm sure he would. He wants timeout now. There is no timeout in the world of professional wrestling.
There is.
There is not.
He knocks Brutus the Barber out cold. He can take all the time he wants.
Oh, yeah.
It's called timeout.
Or out time.
Oh.
Feeble attempt at another sneaky move by the Outlaw. He got trapped again. You can feel the electricity in the air here in the Los Angeles Sports Arena for this one.
Well, they're trying to survive right now. What's Survivor Series going to be like?
Survivor Series is going to be a war.
They're going to start counting the bodies right now.
And your family members playing a very important part, Brain.
Andre the Giant, Ravishing Rick Rude,
Co-Captain,
King Haku. The King Harley Race is back. The Brain Busters.
The guy that you just shoved off to the wayside. Harley Race.
Oh, see, now you're trying to start some trouble.
That guy got sick for a couple of weeks. You went out and got a new king and crowned him. What do you call that?
Sick for a couple of weeks. Hulk Hogan injured him on Saturday night's main event. He injured his stomach. He had to go for major surgery.
Uh-oh. Look out. He's got Miss Betsy in his hand.
Hey, ref. What time you got?
Nailed him with a blunt end of it.
Oh, but it was fine when he had the scissors.
That is rolled steel in the handle of that, folks.
And the scissors is cold steel.
Yeah, but look at the damage you could do. With either, for that matter.
Right.
Rudai out, and the Big Outlaw going right out after him. Now he's got the steel chair. From the hole. Oh, right in the kidney area. And another shot. Oh, rams him once again. I think a disqualification is in order here.
The ring is broken now.
The bottom rope has just snapped.
This is a war. This is just a taste of what Survivor Series is gonna be like. See the importance of reinforcing a ring with just two men in? Think when there's 20 men in it, when there's 10 men in it, what's Survivor Series gonna be like?
Nothing's going to stop this match, though, even though the ring rope is broken. These guys are going to continue on here.
Choke him with the rope, Matt. Choke him. Good move.
Would you stop? Using that bottom rope and raking it right across his throat. Rudai in a whole lot of trouble. You got to start mounting some kind of offense here very shortly, or this one's going to be history.
Oh!
Head first. Oh, look at him shake it off.
Oh, I've never seen this before. Everybody's trying to survive in the World Wrestling Federation.
A block and a right hand and another by Brunei. There's a few lefts for good measure. And the big guy's down on the canvas. And he's giving a sign for the sleeper.
No, he's going to choke him.
Going to put the lights out for him. Sends him in for the ride. Look out. Oh. Right in a kisser. Brutus, second turnbuckle on the inside. Looking perhaps to
find
the sleeper.
Behind you.
No. Right hand, right. Oh, referee went down. As the Big Outlaw went down, he wiped out the referee.
He should be disqualified for that. Brutus the Barber Beefcake deliberately put him in a position where he knocked the referee down so he could choke him like he's doing right
now. There's the sleeper right in the center of the ring, but the referee down and still just about out of it.
Ring that bell, referee.
Brutus going over to take a look at his well-being. Look out.
Come on, Bass. Come on, Bass. Behind him.
From behind the Outlaw, just poised and waiting. Look out, turns around and runs right into a beautiful clothesline.
Come on, ref, get down and count. Beautiful.
He might have knocked him out. Two count.
No! He had him.
Boy, was that close.
What a horrible officiating.
Always finding fault.
Well, he had the man beaten. I shouldn't get involved this much. I shouldn't get that excited.
Brutus sent in, and Brutus ducks underneath a big right hand. High crossbody. He hooked the leg.
He got him. Now the referee's counting faster.
What a move by Brutus to Barber Beefcake. Let's get the official word. Uh-oh, look out, there's Miss Betsy.
Choke him, strangle him, lynch him. Do what you have to do, outlaw.
Brutus forces him backwards into the corner, and now he's got Miss Betsy.
Uh-oh, back.
Surprise, the seed in his hand. But
get the high ground. Get out of here.
Look at this.
Referee, get in the middle. Show some authority.
Look at Brutus step. Miss Betsy, he knows what to do with it. And there he goes, hightailing it out of here. What a victory for this guy.
I'm for reversing the decision and giving the match the bat.
Oh, I'm sure you are. Brutus the Barber Beefcake really doing a number.
I don't want to see any more of this.
We're going to go back and take a look.
No, we're not.
At some of the action that went down earlier on.
Yes, we are. Now look at this, he had him completely defeated here. Good move by Beefcake. There. Now, from my vantage point, he's hooked the tights with the hand there, reached in the crotch area, hooked the tights right there.
He certainly did not. And now, after it's all over, he ends up with Miss Betsy. And believe me, folks, he knew what to do with it. Brutus the Barber, maybe ending this feud once and for all. Coming up next, talk about grudge matches. Hulk Hogan looking to get some revenge on the Big Boss Man. This is going to be a classic.
We're going to read him his rights.